Let me invite you in this new video to a new journey, a very amazing journey in the field of forbidden ancient artifacts depicting highly advanced spaceships. Everyone, what's up? Welcome on Section 51. This is Dose Geek, and we are back for a new subject, right in the field of all these subjects that are very intriguing, very bizarre, very strange, and that constantly trigger our mind. I'm sure that you ever saw that kind of pictures on internet, that kind of pictures showing some strange ancient artifacts which are symbolizing or representing some alien shapes or maybe some ancient astronaut shapes. I'm sure that you ever saw this on the internet. So if you are ready, and before this, thank you again for your support, for your likes, and don't forget to share the video if you liked it. That's always a big support to Section 51 and to all our work, okay? But now, let me invite you to discover a new, incredible, amazing article together, a new article on the website newsintact.com. That's always a pleasure to discover new stories, new amazing stories on this website right now. Okay, so we are on the website newsintact.com, ancient files. As you can see on the picture, that looks very much like ancient astronauts trying to pilot some strange spaceship, spacecraft. That's very strange. What can it be? What can be this strange object? Forbidden ancient artifacts depicting highly advanced spaceships. Published on September the 14th of 2020. They must publish thousands of articles the same day. Did highly advanced spaceships exist in ancient times? That's a good question. According to these following ancient artifacts, yes, as they all showcase the fact that history is not as simple as historians have made it out to be. Take for example these medieval blueprints. They clearly showcase the intricacies of one such multi-stage solid fuel rocket, and as you can tell right off the bat, this is not knowledge that should be going around in medieval times. Yes, we could say that it looks like a rocket. Or if you are not convinced, here you have these instructions which were left off by an Indian guru 10,000 years ago. They clearly showcase how to build an advanced spaceship. How else would you explain this knowledge going around in ancient times? The text outlines aerial routes, metals, metal production, minerals and their use in wars, and varieties of machinery. Okay. The Toprakal space shuttle, on the other hand, is just as impressive as the former, since it dates back to 2,500 years ago, and yet the resemblance to modern day depictions of spaceships is uncanny, to say the least. This carving alone makes it hard to believe in the words of the historians, to say the least. That's to say the least. In two sentences, in less than 1 minute. That's a bit too much, I think. But yes, that's very strange, the shape of the object, and you can see on the picture, you can recognize the legs and the arms, and of course, maybe the head. That makes me think about the space jockey in Alien, the movie, or in Prometheus. But if you're still not on board with this theory, take the word of God while you are at it. That's right, in the Bible, you can actually read about Ezekiel's encounter of one such spaceship as he tries to explain its schematics to us. And I know that there is also the story of Elias, who was taken from Earth to come and to see God. And God, in the Bible, in the stories, God tells him to go back to Earth and to establish justice before Jesus Christ comes to Earth. In fact, in the story, Elias, or Eli in French, is called the Sword of God. He is sent to Earth by God to set the justice, to set the justice on Earth, because all the humans have gone crazy. We left the most interesting part at the ending, as we now have the mysterious lead from Pakal's tomb. On the left we have the sculpture, and on the right the interpretation of that creation. On the other side of it, you can see the king wearing a space suit, getting ready to be sent into space in one such advanced spaceship. Secrets of Topracale. The shuttle is a well-known artifact among ancient astronaut investigators. Author and investigator Zekaria Sitchin traced this artifact down in a museum in Istanbul, Turkey. It was not on display because the curators thought it was a falsification. The artifact, named after the Topracale site where it was found, seemed to resemble a rocket ship with an astronaut sitting in it, and therefore it could not be very old, so they thought. Topracale, located near Lake Vani in the Caucasus region, is an extraordinary site itself. In ancient times, the 9th century before Christ, it was known as Tushpa, the capital of the kingdom of Urartu. Tushpa was founded by the building of a fortress at the west end of the citadel of Van. The walls of this ancient Urartian fortress, which is often simply referred to as Topracale, are special because they are built with Cyclopean masonry. This means that the walls are constructed without mortar, with huge stone blocks. This construction method was already legendary for the ancient Greeks, who imagined such walls could only be built by a race of giants called Cyclops. Cyclops. Cyclopean masonry is found in Europe in Mycenaean buildings, but also on other continents, for example at Machu Picchu, Peru, and other pre-Columbian sites. The fortress at Tushpa has inscriptions of the Urartian king Sarduri I in Assyrian. Sarduri I reigned from 834 to 828 before Christ and is best known for moving the capital of the Urartu kingdom to Tushpa. It is remarkable that the Tushpa inscriptions, besides claiming that Sarduri I founded the site, describe the transportation of the giant blocks from a town called Alnu. Such inscriptions usually describe conquests and victories, glorious facts about a particular ruler. Why would the writers have taken the trouble to describe a simple building process? Maybe because it was not so simple and the writers needed to explain how the blocks, weighing up to 30 or 40 tons each and with a bulk of over 5 cubic meters, got there. The location of Alnu is thought to be on the northeast shore of Lake Van. The blocks could not have been transported far, scholars argue. The purpose of the megalithic structure remains undetermined. Was it actually Sarduri I who built it, or is the structure much older and did he try to claim it as his own? Is it a coincidence that at such a mysterious site, an object was found that looks like a rocket ship? Zekaria Sitchin describes this object as a sculpted scale model of what, to modern eyes, looks like a cone-nosed rocket ship, powered by a cluster of four exhaust engines in the back surrounding a larger exhaust engine. The rocket ship has room for a sole pilot actually shown and included in a sculpture. Could the blocks have been transported from much further away, using technology like rocket ships to put them in place? This is just speculation, of course, but why would the ancient inhabitants of Tushpa create such an artifact? If they had never seen airplanes or rocket ships before? Yes, that's a good question. Because the shape, the disposition, the placement, the setup, the setting of the pilot and the shape of the object, when you don't have the basis, the scientific basis and the technological notions, you cannot invent very easily all these shapes and these combination of shapes, of mechanism, and of course with the pilot. And also the clothes, the armor of the pilot. Here we are on the website Ancient Origins, reconstructing the story of humanity's past. An article published on June 2018, ancient inscriptions decoded at the spectacular temple of the Mayan king Pakal in the rainforests of Mexico. The Mayan king Pakal. The glyphs were deciphered in 2015 and read "The House of the Nine Sharpened Spears," as revealed by a team of researchers led by epigraphist Guillermo Bernal Romero from the National Autonomous University of Mexico. And if we go down, we come to this sculpture, the magnificent sarcophagus lid of Pakal. In an incredible find, Mexican archaeologist Alberto Ruiz Lullier, sometimes called the Hitchcock of archaeology, was doing temple excavations in the rainforest in the early 1950s when he uncovered a floor panel which hid a secret staircase choked with rubble. When the debris was finally cleared after 4 years, Ruiz was able to squeeze into the revealed burial chamber deep inside the pyramid, which held the untouched tomb of an ancient king. Pakal had been buried with several male and female human sacrifices and grave goods, included jaded figures, jewelry and a jade funerary mask found on the king's remains. But do they say more about the sarcophagus of the King Pakal? There was an underground water tunnel who was used to allow the Pakal's spirit to move into the underworld, and there is a popular legend saying that Pakal flew off in a spaceship, but the water tunnel suggests that he may have floated down the waterway instead. So we have the mention here of a spaceship as it is described in the sculpture. As Gonzalez said, there is nothing to do with spaceships. Okay? So that's the end of the discussion, okay? We cannot negotiate. The spaceships have nothing to do here, okay? This is my scientific conclusion. The Guardian writes, the Maya civilization, which developed hieroglyphic writing, a calendar and astronomical system, reached its peak of influence between AD 250 and 900, extending its reach over what is now Guatemala, Belize and Honduras. Okay, I think that that's all with the theory of the lead of Pakal, of the King Pakal, on this culture. Let's go back here in the article. If you turn the picture clockwise by 90 degrees, effectively you can imagine that the King Pakal would be in position to pilot some kind of spaceship, like in the interpretation on the right. That's very strange. So that allows us, I don't have the need to watch the video about five mysterious ancient spaceships, but we can go to another article on the website listverse.com, which is talking about 10 mysterious artifacts that are allegedly alien. It was published on 2013, so 7 years ago, okay? Some say alien life forms have visited Earth throughout history. However, such claims are difficult to prove. And I can say you that's today, that's still difficult to prove. Most UFO sightings and abductions are easy to dismiss as hoaxes or simple misunderstandings. But, because we always have to have a but, what about the times when the little green man actually leaves something behind? Or the artifacts people from ancient times have constructed to honor what could only be visitors from other planets? There are many strange objects in the world, both enigmatic and man-made, that are said to be proof of alien life. Number 10, the Russian UFO tooth wheel. A Russian man found a strange piece of machinery from Vladivostok, the administrative capital of the Primorsky Krai area. The object resembled a piece of tooth wheel and was embedded in a piece of coal he was using to light a fire. And once the fire was enlightened, poof, no more proofs of alien on Earth. But it was warmer in the room. Also, discarded pieces of old machines are not uncommon in Russia. The man became curious and showed his find to some scientists. Testing revealed that the toothed object was almost pure aluminium and almost certainly artificially made. Also, it was 300 million years old. This raised some interesting questions as aluminium of this purity and shape can't form naturally, and humans didn't figure out how to make it until 1825. Curiously, the object also resembles parts that are used in microscopes and other delicate technical devices. Also, conspiracy theorists have been quick to declare the find a part of an alien spaceship. The scientists researching it are not willing to jump to conclusions and wish to run further tests in order to learn more about the mysterious artifact. Number 9, the Guatemala Stonehead. In the 1930s, explorers found an enormous, eloquently made sandstone statue in the middle of Guatemalan jungle. The face carved in the stone didn't resemble the facial features of the Maya or any of the other people known to have populated the lands. In fact, its elongated cranium and fine features didn't seem to belong in the history books at all. At first sight, like this, it makes me think about, you know, the monumental sculpture of the face in the movie Prometheus. The face of the engineers. Researchers have claimed that the statue's unique features depict a member of an ancient alien civilization that was far more advanced than any of the pre-Hispanic races of America we know about. Some even speculated the head might just be a part of a much larger construct underneath. This was found to be untrue. Of course, there is a chance that the statue might be the work of a more recent artist or even a complete hoax. There is a chance. Sadly, we will probably never find out for sure. The head was used for target practice by revolutionary troops and its features have been destroyed to near obscurity. Very strange story. Number 8, the Williams Enigmalite. With the the plug, if you want to turn on your air dryer. In 1998, a hiker named John G. Williams noticed a strange metallic protrusion in the dirt. He dug up a strange-looking rock, which upon cleaning turned out to have a weird electrical component attached to it. The electric device was clearly man-made and somewhat resembled an electrical plug. That's what I was trying to say. The rock has since become a well-known mystery in UFO enthusiast circles. It has featured in UFO magazine and, according to Williams, 14 times, a famed magazine devoted to mysterious phenomena. Williams, an electrical engineer, says the electronic component embedded in the stone has not been glued or welded into the granite. In fact, the rock probably formed around the device. Maybe. But a very long time ago, maybe at the time of the 2,900 million years footprint. Many believe that the so-called Williams Enigmalite is a hoax, as Williams refuses to break it, but is willing to sell it for $500,000. Maybe we would have the answer if he could accept to break the stone, maybe. Also, the stone device does bear a certain resemblance to heat rocks that are commonly used to keep tropical pet lizards warm. Still, geological analysis has apparently determined that the stone is around 100,000 years old, which, if true, would mean the device inside can't possibly be of human creation. Williams is confident enough to let anyone research the anomalite on three conditions. He must be present, the rock must remain unarmed, and he will not have to pay for the research. Of course, because maybe he's not rich, he's not so rich. Number 7, ancient aeroplanes. Ah, we are back with these objects. Incas and other pre-Columbian people left behind some extremely puzzling trinkets. Some of the strangest are probably the so-called ancient aeroplanes, which are small golden figures that closely resemble modern jet planes. Yes, that's very strange. Originally thought to be zoomorphic, meant to resemble animals, the statues were soon found to have features that look very much like fighter planes' wings, stabilizing tails and even landing gears. Personally, I don't know birds looking like that kind of shape. They were aerodynamic enough that when ancient astronaut believers made model planes with their proportions and fitted them with propellers and jet engines, they flew perfectly. All of this has led to speculation that the Incas may have been in contact with likely extraterrestrial people who were able to build advanced jet planes and who perhaps even possessed the technology themselves. Well, that or these wonderful statuettes might just be artistic representations of bees, flying fish, hard to believe, or other winged creatures. As always, the beauty is in the eye of the beholder. Number 6, the Ubaid Lizard Men. Wow. A bit scary. Al Ubaid archaeological site in Iraq is a gold mine for archaeologists and historians. It has yielded numerous objects from a pre-Sumerian time called the Ubaid period, 5900 to 4000 before Christ. However, some of these objects are quite disturbing. A number of Ubaid statues depict strange lizard-like humanoid figures in unique, unceremonious poses that seem to indicate they were not gods, such as the animal-headed deities of Egypt, but rather a race of lizard people. Of course, the statues have been drawn into stories and theories of reptilian aliens that used to roam the earth and perhaps still do. According to conspiracy theorists, although this seems unlikely, their true nature remains a mystery. Number 5, the Sri Lanka meteorite fossils. Researchers who analyzed the remains of a meteorite that fell in Sri Lanka found that their subject was something more than just pieces of space rock. It was an alien artifact in the most literal sense, an artifact made of actual aliens. Two separate studies have found that the meteorite contains fossils and algae that are clearly of extraterrestrial origin. Professor Chandra Wickramasinghe, the leading researcher on the first study, says the fossils provide compelling evidence of panspermia. The hypothesis that life exists throughout the universe and is spread by meteorites and other solid space debris. However, he is not without his critics. Wickramasinghe just happens to be a noted panspermia enthusiast with a tendency to claim that almost everything is of extraterrestrial origin. What's more, the traces of life the meteorite contains are actually freshwater species commonly found on Earth, which seems to indicate the object has been contaminated during its time on our planet. Number 4, the Summer's Triumph Tapestry. The tapestry known as Summer's Triumph was created in Bruges the capital of West Flanders province in the Flemish region of Belgium around 1538. Currently it resides in the Bayerisches National Museum. Sumner's Triumph is famous or infamous among conspiracy theorists because it clearly depicts a number of distinctly UFO-like objects flying in the skies. Although their presence is baffling, some speculate they may have been added in the tapestry, which depicts a victorious ruler's ascension to power, in order to connect the UFOs to the ruler as a symbol of divine intervention. This, of course, raises more questions than answers, such as why would the 16th century Belgians recognize flying saucers and mentally connect them with divinity? But let me recall you that Belgium is a country with a big history, a rich history with UFOs. There was a lot of UFO sightings in the history of this country. So that's not very surprising. You must know this that painting, the glorification of the Eucharist. An Italian painter named Ventura Salimbeni is responsible for one of the most mysterious altar paintings in history, Disputa of the Eucharist, a 16th century painting also known as the glorification of the Eucharist. Is an alternate term for the Holy Communion, is a three-part work. The bottom two parts are relatively normal. They depict a number of religious authorities and an altar. However, the top part shows the Holy Trinity, Father, Son, and a dove depicting the Holy Ghost looking upon them. But you can see that when you look closely to the picture, you can see that there is a disc shape around the dove, and there is a strange triangle just behind the head. I think this is God, the Father. So the dove, the Holy Trinity is looking upon them and holding what seems to be a space satellite. That's very intriguing. And again, this was in the 16th century. The object is large and spherical with a metallic finish, telescopic antennas and strange lights. In fact, it heavily resembles an old Sputnik satellite. What if this was really an old Sputnik satellite which traveled in space-time and went back, which was trapped in an interdimensional gate or portal and traveled through space-time and went back in the 16th century when the painter discovered it. Wow, bingo! Take notes when you watch the video. Also, UFO enthusiasts and ancient astronaut theorists have often claimed the Disputa as proof of extraterrestrial life or perhaps time travel. You know, you see, I hold the truth, I know, I'm sure. Deep in my mind, inside of me, I know that I hold the truth. I'm sure that the truth of all the universe is deep inside every one of us. We just have to focus on the real life, the real things, and the real humanity, the real love inside every one of us. And we will find the truth somewhere. Experts have been quick to debunk such notions. Of course, according to them, the orb is a spherea mundi, a globe-like representation of the universe that used to be common in religious art. Yes, of course, with big antennas, because the antennas were very used in the 16th century in order to capt the frequencies. Yes. I like the theories of debunkers. The strange lights on the satellite are merely the sun and the moon, and its antennas are actually scepter ones that act as symbols of authority for the father and the son. Yes, of course, and I would say moreover that it symbolizes joysticks for video games, because everyone knows that the Holy Trinity, the God and Father, were playing, were hard gamers. They were constantly playing video games and they were streaming on Twitch. Thank you for making me laughing. Number two, the Mexican government's Maya artifacts. Ah, yes. That's the big deal. The story goes like this. In 2012, the Mexican government released a number of Maya artifacts they had been protecting for 80 years as state secrets. These objects were retrieved from an unexplored pyramid that was found under another pyramid in Calakmul, the site of one of the most powerful ancient Maya cities. A government-sanctioned documentary by Raul Julia Levy, the son of famous actor Raul Julia, and financier Elizabeth Thierryo, ex-wife of a former publisher of the San Francisco Chronicle, featured a number of these finds, most of which clearly depict UFOs and alien visitors. The case may seem fairly enticing, but once you look closer, a strange pattern of fraud begins to emerge. Ah, okay. Both of the documentarians seem to be lying about something. Julia Levy doesn't appear to be who he claims to be. Raul Julia's widow has publicly called out a con man named Salvador Alba Fuentes. According to her, Salvador is attempting to ride on her late husband's fame and is going around telling everyone his name is, yes, Raul Julia Levy. Meanwhile, Thierryo has shut down the production of the documentary and sued her partner, accusing Julia Levy of stealing her documentary and misusing filming equipment. Okay. What's more, there seems to be very little scientific proof of the authenticity of the artifacts, and the pictures that have emerged online are less than concrete evidence. Perhaps the artifacts were cheap fakes manufactured by a local artisan. Perhaps the officials had second thoughts about the documentary and ordered Thierryo to shut it down by any means necessary. Whatever the truth behind these strange artifacts is, their case is far from convincing. And number one, the top, the Betts Mystery Sphere with Jesus Christ. Yeah. When the Betts family was examining the damage of a strange fire that had decimated 88 acres of their woodland, they made a strange discovery. A silvery sphere, about 20 centimeters, 8 inches in diameter, completely smooth except for a strange elongated triangle symbol. Initially thinking it might be a NASA gadget or even a Soviet spy satellite, they eventually decided it was most likely just a souvenir. On a moment's whim, they decided to take it with them. 2 weeks later, the family's son was strumming a guitar in the same room as the sphere. Suddenly, the sphere started reacting to his tunes, emitting a strange throbbing sound and a resonance that deeply disturbed the family's dog. Soon, the Betts family found the orb had other strange properties. It could stop and change directions when pushed across the floor, eventually returning to the person who pushed it like a faithful dog. It seemed to draw power from solar energy, becoming noticeably more active on bright days. It started looking like something or someone was controlling the sphere. It would occasionally emit low frequency rattling and vibrations, like there was a motor running inside. It seemed to avoid falling and crashing at all costs, as if to protect something inside it. Maybe there is a small alien inside. It even managed to completely defy the laws of gravity and climb up a slanted table to avoid falling. A media frenzy ensued. Respected papers such as the New York Times and the London Daily sent reporters to witness the miracle sphere, which repeated its tricks to countless people. Even scientists and representatives of the military were impressed, although the Betts family wouldn't let them take the sphere for closer examination. However, that soon changed as the sphere took a turn for the worse. It started exhibiting poltergeist-like behavior. Doors started slamming shut at night and strange organ music would fill the house out of the blue. At that point, the family decided to find out what the sphere really was. The Navy analyzed it and found it was a perfectly ordinary, if high quality, stainless steel ball. Okay. Nice information. Thank you for the study. To this day, it's not entirely clear that what the mysterious alien sphere is. However, there have been many theories attempting to explain its possible nature. The most plausible of these is, incidentally, the most mundane. 3 years before the Betts family found the orb, an artist named James Derling Jones was driving the area where it was found. On the luggage rack on his car roof were a number of stainless steel balls meant for sculpture he was making, some of which dropped off during the bumpy ride. These balls matched the exact description of the Betts sphere and were balanced enough to roll around at the slightest provocation. The Betts family lived in an old house with uneven floors, so such a ball would appear to behave erratically. These balls could even emit a rattling sound thanks to tiny metal shavings stuck inside during the manufacturing process. Although this doesn't explain all of the reported phenomena, it certainly casts a shadow over all the mysterious ghost ball from outer space rhetoric. I don't know what to think about all this. Of course, as always, we have a lot of comments. You can't assume someone is crazy because they are open-minded to something that could very well be true. In fact, a lot more educated and sane people believe there is life somewhere else in the universe, unlike those non-educated sheeple who will follow what they think is normal to believe. However, it was very interesting because personally I discovered new things, new stuff in that field, and that was very interesting. And you? Did you find this new video interesting? Did you learn something? Are you convinced that some of these objects have alien origins? Are they the proofs of the existence, the existence of ancient aliens on Earth in old times, in ancient times? What did inspire the artists, the creators of these artifacts? Once again, it's very difficult to invent all these shapes, these concepts, when you have low education, when you live in a primitive state. Even when you do drawings, when you do paintings, you can't invent something like that. When you learn, when you start painting, and even when you are an expert, you are still using models. So I think it's not pure coincidence. Yes. So guys, did you like the video? What do you think about all this? This is a very strong subject, very important, very interesting. Please leave your comments below the video. Don't forget to like, to share the video, to subscribe to the channel if you are new here on Section 51. Don't forget to have a look to our private space for the members. Don't forget to visit our Spreadshirt shop where you can find goodies, t-shirts, etc., etc., clothes about in the area of Section 51 in our universe. This was Dos Geek on Section 51. I send you big kisses. I send you two positive energy, positive microwaves. And of course, live long and prosper. I promise you, I will come back very soon in a new video on a new subject, a new amazing subject. So thank you for watching. Big kisses. This was Dos Geek. See you next time in a new video. Bye.